series done with, because I've only done two episodes from it. That's fine. So we've done the SAS, that was our first one, just for a bit of patriotism. And we've also done the GSG-9. So I think next we'll do the GIGN, the French counterterrorism unit. So I think there's a... we'll just start with Twitch, I think. So Twitch, if we look at her loadout, she has an F2 assault rifle, which for some reason I don't have my skin or anything on it. Okay, she also has a 417, which is a single fire marksman rifle. Or she can take the SGCQB shotgun, which I don't know why you would ever use. I don't know. For secondary weapons, like all GIGN operators, she can take either the LFP 586 revolver, 6 shots, 6 kills, or she can take the P9 handgun, which is just a normal, quote-unquote, magazine-fed 9mm pistol which she has. So, and for her gadgets, she has a breaching charge, or a claymore. So her unique ability is called the RSD Model 1 Shock Drone. So she uses 2 shock drones to disable traps or injure enemies, deploys the first shock drone during the preparation phase, and then she keeps one on her when you actually get sent in. And she's a 2-armor, 2-speed operator, so middle of the road in terms of speed. So, oh, there's... I didn't actually know that was there, all the statistics. I have terrible statistics. I'm terrible at this game. Anyway, so moving on to her operator bio. Her name is Emmanuel Picon. I don't know. I'm taking French for A-level, I don't know. Her nickname is Twitch. You should know by now. She was born on the 12th of October, 1988. So fairly young, actually. Because that would only make her 29, I think. Unless I've got my maths wrong. Yeah, 29. So she's not that old compared to some people, like Thatcher or Montagne, but we'll get to him. She's born in Nancy, France. That's a bit of casual racism. She weighs 100, by the little pop-up, by the way, in the side. I just wanted to mute my in-game volume because it was getting really annoying. Sorry, carry on. She's 168 centimeters tall, 1.68 meters. I don't know what that is in Imperial. I detest the Imperial system. And she weighs 58 kilos, which is only about 2 kilos heavier than me. So she's really not that heavy. Speedy person, I suppose. Anyway, born in the historic town. So this is her background. Born in the historic town of Nancy, Picon. We're going to have to just Picon. Grew up in a family that valued education, particularly math and science. Early participation in sponsored computer programming competitions led to her joining the Army Cadets at 16. Physiological profile. Picon demonstrates an affinity for complex robotic systems and mechanical processes due to an early exposure to analytical problem solving. This ability transcends academia. Unlike many engineers who have propensity to be emotionally disconnected or apathetic, Picon is strongly intuitive and empathetic. She believes that technology's best use is to improve the quality of life. This principle motivates Twitch in her military service. Training French Army engineers, the Eugenie and the GIGN. And she's been deployed to Chad and Libya. Fun fact, I think, don't quote me on this, but I think Chad just literally translates to lake, because it's like a lake or something. Notes, despite her young age, see, she is young. Twitch shows exemplary promise as a support specialist. At 20 years old, she was the youngest operative to ever be accepted into the GIGN. That's pretty good. A support specialist, she has not a support, she runs in there and blasts people with her F2, but whatever. Let me just equip it instead of the shotgun. Moving on to Montagna, possibly my favourite GIGN operator, just because he's pretty neat. So let's look at his loadout. His primary weapon, quote unquote, is an extendable shield. So you can have it like this, or deployed, where it covers your whole body. So I've got a little unicorn charm on there. Like all the other GIGN operators, he's got the LFP revolver, or the P9 handgun, magazine fed, yada yada yada. He's also got a smoke grenade or a stun grenade, depending on which one you take. So his unique ability is Lorok. He can expand his extendable shield to offer full protection while standing. So he's basically just like a guy, a bullet sponge, basically an infinite bullet sponge. And he's a 3-armor, 1-speed operator. So just, you know, gotta wait for him to catch up. He's got a video as well, because he's like an original operator. Pretty neat. His actual name is Giles Touré. Giles Touré. I don't know. His nickname is obviously Montagna. He was born on the 11th of October, 1968. So, nearly 50. Christ almighty. Montagna's nearly 50. He must be doing quite well then. He was born in Bordeaux, France. He is 190 centimeters tall, which is very tall. That is exceedingly tall. And he weighs 90 kilos, which is probably just like pure muscle to hulk around his shield all day. Background: the son of an army officer and a school teacher, the family was stationed near Bordeaux. A few years after Touré graduated from high school, he became a member of the National Gendarmerie. I really need to like pronounce better, speak better. A career policeman. There's actually a mistake in the background. There's a mistake in the operator profile, I think. Because it says a career policeman, where it really should be policeman, shouldn't it? I don't know. Ubisoft, Gooby, please fix. Touré has dedicated his life to the defense work. His dedication and commitment to the ideals of the National Gendarmerie allowed him to obtain a position with the GIGN. Touré is considered highly dependable by his peers. His steady nerves have allowed him to successfully take control of complex, high-stress situations during the tenure of his career. As a trainer, Touré is stern with the new recruits, but always tries to remain fair. He prefers to lead by example, and he also leads from the front by carrying a massive shield. His training is the National Gendarmerie and the GIGN. Relevant experience: he was in the 1994 French airline hijacking, which is actually a really interesting event. There's a really good movie made about it. The Assault is its English name. L'Assaut, I think, is its French name. And it's really good. Go watch it. It's on Amazon, I think. He's won several CQB awards at SWAT competitions in Europe and the US. He's had extensive urban CQB training and is a certified GIGN trainer. So, he's doing alright. Iron Shotgun, the SGCQB. Like both the defending operators, he can take the MP5 with the collapsible retractable stock. I don't know which MP5 model that makes it, but there we are. And he can also take a P90. He's got the same two handguns as all the others, the revolver and then the regular double action. He can take a deployable shield or barbed wire. Okay, so his unique ability is the MPD-0 stim pistol, which fires a hypodermic shot to revive himself or teammates from a distance. Can also provide a temporary boost, so it increases their HP by 40. So you can overheal people, but the overheal sort of slowly goes away. He's a 3-armor, 1-speed operator. His real name is Gustav Kateb. Gustav Kateb. Just to pronounce it in a really English way. He was born on the 16th of September, 1977, which means his 40th birthday is actually coming up really soon. When I'm recording this, it's in like 20 days. So, happy birthday for then, I suppose, Doc. He was born in Paris, France. His height is 177 centimeters, and he weighs 74 kilos. Kateb grew up in an affluent family in Paris's 16th arrondissement. I'm fairly sure we learned this word as part of our French GCSE, but whatever, we'll just roll with it. At 20, he abandoned a potentially prominent private medical practice, that is a lot of P's, in favour of a career with the French Defence Health Service. Kateb demonstrates a high degree of empathy for human suffering. He is a rare, genuine altruist. He sees military service, especially the role of CUTs like GIGN, as noble in their dedication to protecting civilians. He considers the front line his natural habitat, as it provides him with the opportunity to have direct influence and impact on the, and impact the welfare of his unit. There we are. His proclivity for conflict resolution makes him a valuable asset. So he's trained at the Université Paris Descartes, Bachelor of Science, Health, Master Toxicology, and Ecotoxicology, Doctorate in Medicine, Toxicology, Chemistry, Imagery. I don't know how you're supposed to read that list. Maybe I'm just weird. He was part of the French Defence Health Service, part of the Army Special Forces Brigade, and then part of the GIGN. He's had two tours of duty, God knows where, and he's worked with Doctors Without Borders. He's certified to practice in 10 countries with Doctors Without Borders. Although, there's another mistake there, I think, because doctors shouldn't have the apostrophe, because it's just Doctors Without Borders. It's not possessive, but I don't know, my inner little grammar thing coming out. I am really anal about grammar, and it really annoys a lot of my friends when I'm just like, you can't say that, you shouldn't, that's wrong, I'm sorry, it's fewer, and that really annoys them. So anyway, this is Rook. He's our final GIGN operator. So let's look at his loadout. He can take the P90 submachine gun, which I'm fairly sure only Doc had. Maybe they gave it to Rook, I don't know. He also has the MP5 and the SGCQB. He takes the two sidearms that both all GIGN operators have, and he can take either a deployable shield or an impact grenade. So his unique ability is the R1N Rhino Armor. He drops a supply bag full of armor plates for his team to use, and he is a 3 armor, 1 speed operator, which probably makes the GIGN, like, the slowest CTU in the game, maybe. I don't know. Maybe the Spetsnaz. Because they've also got some slow-ass operators. Anyway, his real name is Julien Nizan, and he hails from Tours, France. He was born on January the 6th, 1990, making him extremely young, 27. He is 175 centimeters tall, making him about as tall as me. And he weighs 72 kilos, making him a lot heavier than me. In school, Nizan excelled in athletics, specifically in track and field, which is why he's the slowest class of operator, of course. The youngest son of a working class family, he enlisted with the Gendarmerie Nationale at 18 and found himself assigned to the Highway Patrol Unit. During basic training, Nizan discovered his aptitude, for firearms, a skill that he would continue to develop and master during his time with the Gendarmerie Nationale. Nizan's skill with a rifle attracted the attention of the GIGN. So his skill with a rifle is why he only uses submachine guns. Okay. This is like a backwards-ass background, but whatever, we'll just roll with it. Nizan is idealistic and trusting. He can be impulsive and must self-regulate in order to remain on task. When his focus is clear, he is decisive and driven to complete the task at hand. So he's trained with the Gendarmerie Nationale and the GIGN. Relevant experience. He is a GIGN marksmanship champion, which is pretty neat. And notes. He performs trust exercises with all the new recruits, which is what you see in his operator video, where they shoot the plate on their chest as like a form of trust. And he's fluent in English, as he studied with an American professor at secondary school, which is pretty neat. So there is Rook. Pretty neat. Probably my second favourite GIGN character. The order's probably Montagne, Rook, Doc, and then Twitch. Or maybe Twitch and then Doc, I don't know. I don't have a huge preference, I know I just like playing Montagne and Rook. But there we are. So, that's been the GIGN. Thank you so much for listening and watching, I guess. There's a little card that's been throughout the video, so you can vote on which CTU I go through next. And thank you so much for watching, and sweet dreams.